Recently, Xiaomi updated their 120W GaN fast charger from USB-A to USB-C. It only takes about 15 minutes to fully charge some Xiaomi smartphones, such as Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus. Today, ChargerLab will tear down this 120W GaN fast charger. By the way, we also turned down the dual-port 65W fast charger of Xiaomi. You can click the upper right corner to take a look. After opening the box, here is the charger and cable. The dual USB-C ports are orange. It can support 6A current. The length of the cable is 1 meter. This charger is similar to the previous generation. It adopts glossy shell and is printed with GaN and 120W. The color of USB-C port is the same as cables. Flip to the other side, we can see the model is MDY-13-ET. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.7 amp. We can clearly see that the new model is slightly smaller. Let's see its size. The length and width are 55mm, the height is 28mm, and weight is about 138 grams. Use ChargerLab PowerZ KT002 to test the particle. It supports Samsung 5V 2A DCP and QC2, QC3, PD3. But the maximum power of PD particle is 65W, and it supports 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A. The 20V, 6A, 120W is Xiaomi's private particle. Next, let's tear it down. The entire PCB module is filled with thermal adhesives. Here is a graphite thermal pad on the right. The AC wire is connected to the plug. After cleaning up the thermal adhesives, we can see lots of components are on the front. The planar transformer is on the back, used for reducing the size and thickness. ChargerLab found that this charger can power the QR flyback switching power supply after PFC boost. The output voltage will depend on the load and be controlled by particle chip. Remove all the components on the front. There is a rectifier bridge, a GaN IC, and a particle chip. Then let's analyze the components one by one. The input fuse is insulated with heat shrinkable tube. The varistor is used for input over voltage protection. It will turn on when the AC input exceeds the safe range. The surge suppressor can reduce the current surge of the power supply. Common mode choke is also insulated with heat shrinkable tube. The other common mode choke is wound with flat copper tape. Safety X capacitor is 0.33 microfarad. The input bridge rectifier is marked with LMB10L30. Another same bridge rectifier is on the front, used to dissipate heat evenly. Those are two film capacitors. The first is 1 microfarad, 450 volts, and the other is 0.68 microfarad, 450 volts. The toroidal core inductor is used for filtering. The input PFC controller comes from Silgi SY5072B. The built-in boost converter uses quasi-resonant switches to achieve high efficiency and optimized EMI performance. The switching transistor of PFC boost comes from Navitas NV6134. This is a GaN IC with highly integrated drive and protection circuit. It also adopts a larger pad for better heat dissipation performance. This small cube is a PFC boost inductor. This is a fast recovery diode marked with ES5JCR and used for PFC rectification. Here is a diode used to charge the input electrolytic capacitor. And the input electrolytic capacitors come from Semaxon. Three of them are 400 volts, 15 microfarad. The other one is 400 volts, 22 microfarad. The power supply capacitor of master control chip comes from Capaxon. Specs is 100 volts, 10 microfarad. And the master control chip comes from ON Semiconductor NCP1342, a high-frequency quasi-resonant flyback PWM controller. It integrates active X2 capacitor discharge feature and supports external thermistor for overheating protection. The primary thermistor is in the lower left corner, used to detect the temperature. Because of the planar transformer, some components are on the PCB of the planar transformer, which can improve the power density. This GaN IC comes from Navitas NV6134 and is used for primary switching power supply. The synchronous rectifier controller comes from MPS, model is MP6908A. It supports operating modes of DCM, CCM, QR, ACF, and the highest operating frequency is 600 kHz. It also supports synchronous rectifiers driven by standard voltage and logic voltage. The synchronous rectifier adopts Vanguard VSP003N10H, which adopts PDFN5×6 package, 100 volts, 3.8 milliohm. It can be driven by 10 volts logic voltage. The solid capacitor for output filter comes from Barrel. Two of them are 470 microfarad, 25 volts. Another solid capacitor also comes from Barrel, 25 volts, 470 microfarad. Those two Everlight optocouplers are used for feedback circuit of output voltage. The protocol chip comes from Injonic IP2729, which is Xiaomi's customized model, so it can support Xiaomi's private protocol. The output VBUS MOSFET comes from Vanguard VS3698AE, which adopts PDFN3333 package, 30 volts, 3 milliohm. Finally, the USB-C port is also customized. Well, that's all components of this charger. The 20V 6A 120V is still Xiaomi's private protocol and can only be activated in specific models. It also supports USB PD protocol, but the maximum power is 65 watts. So if you have Xiaomi phone that supports and want to upgrade the dual USB-C cable, you can consider this charger. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you want to see the teardown of other Xiaomi fast chargers, you can click the corners to take a look. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!